Hello friends, I am Ajit Agarwal and in this class of chemistry I will discuss you the process involved during metallurgy. In the last video I have already discussed the term used in the metallurgy. Now I will discuss you what processes are involved during the metallurgy. Here we can do the metallurgy in following four steps. Step 1 is concentration of ore, also known as dressing of ore. It is done by following four methods: magnetic separation, froth flotation method, hydraulic method and chemical method. Okay, so by these four method you can remove the impurity by physical methods. Okay, so after doing concentration we will use second step. If there is no ore in form of oxide, then we will have to convert them into oxide, because metal oxides are easy to reduce. So in this step, first we will convert concentrated ore to oxide, and it is done by two methods: roasting and calcination. Roasting is basically done for sulfide ores. I will discuss you in just now by doing these reactions. Okay. Sulfide ores and calcium done for carbonate ores. In roasting you will take excess air, and calcination the absence of air. Okay, after converting concentrated ore to oxide we will do reduction reaction in step 3 to change metal oxide to metal. Then step 4 we will refine impure metal to obtain pure metal. It is already done in the chapter electrolysis. Okay, in which more important part is electrolytic method. So these are the four steps: concentration of ore, concentrated ore to oxide conversion, reduction of metal oxide to metal, and finally refining. Okay, now we will explain you how these steps can be carried out. The first step is concentration of ore, removal of impurities by physical method. The first method is electromagnetic separation. This process is done when either ore or matrix is magnetic in nature. Okay, here what will you do in this process? If there is such type of ore which is either magnetic or matrix is magnetic, in that case first you will crush the ore and then drop that crushed ore over this belt. This leather belt revolves over these two wheels. The back wheel is non-magnetic and the front wheel is electromagnetic wheel. The back wheel, which is non-magnetic, is connected to motor. When motor starts, it continuously moves, as well as this leather belt and electromagnetic wheel. Here I have drawn these diagrams. White portion shows pure ore, which is magnetic ore, and these dots represents matrix. The black dot represents matrix, which is non-magnetic. These magnetic ore stick up to the point where this wheel leaves the belt. Okay, jahan belt leave karegi wahan tak stick rahega, and after that this ore will collected in this container. Ore will separate out and the non-magnetic matrix will fall off at this edge. Okay, it will collect it far behind. So similarly, you can in this way you can separate ore from the non-magnetic matrix. Okay, next method is froth flotation method. Froth flotation method is generally done for sulfide ores. In this method, you have to take a steel tank in which there is a solution having pine oil, water, crushed ore. Okay. And a frothing agent is also used, which is known as potassium ethyl xanthate. This helps in making froth. What will you do to this solution? You will take a tube having a pipe, few holes are there. Compressed air is passed through this pipe, air starts circulating the mixture. After few time you will see that ore will come with pine oil in form of froth on the upper surface. Because foam is lighter, it will collect on the top, which is then collected to the container next to it. After a few time, the froth will melt and you will get the ore. While matrix will heavier by that water and settle down. So matrix will remove behind and ore will collect in the next container. Next method is gravity separation method. It is done for denser ores. If ore is denser, then you have to first crush it and then flow it with water. There is a sloping surface having some grooves. ये बिल्कुल वैसे ही जैसे कि आप लोग स्टेयर से सफाई करते by mean of water. In that case, heavy particle will set at the joint of the stairs. Similarly, in the same way, denser or particle will fit in these grooves and lighter impurities or water washable impurity will move behind. Impurity will collect at the bottom and you will collect the ore from these grooves. And this is chemical method. It is basically used in the extraction of aluminium from bauxite. In this, you have to use the chemical or reagent which is concentrated sodium hydroxide solution. It is known that bauxite is Al2O3.2H2O, which is amphoteric in nature, can easily react with this and leaving behind the impurities. This reagent is used in Beer's process during extraction of aluminium. So this was the first step. Now, second step. It is conversion of concentrated ore to oxide. Two methods are there, roasting and calcination, as I have told you just a few times before. Roasting process, it is done. What is its definition? Process of heating concentrated ore to oxide in presence of excess air to high temperature before it is reduced to metal. This may come in form of a difference. Okay, in the board exam there may be a difference between roasting and calcination. First you have to write down the definition in the exact these words, before it is reduced to metal. This is the keyword ye zarur hona chahiye isme. And in this you have to heat the ore in absence of air or very limited supply of air, not sufficient to melt the ore. Itna heat karoge melt na ho. So this is basically done, roasting is basically done for sulfide ores. In this, you have to heat zinc sulfide in presence of excess air to form sulfur dioxide gas. It will remove out, leaving behind zinc oxide. In the same manner, if you have zinc carbonate ore, means calcination process done for carbonate ores, which is heated at temperature less than 4 degrees Celsius to form zinc oxide and CO2. This carbon dioxide will remove out and leaving behind zinc oxide. So by this way you can see that we can get zinc oxide from concentrated ore. The next step is the reduction process of metal oxide to metal. So it is used by seeing that what is the activity series. This activity series of metals: potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, lead, hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver. Top 5 metals, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, have a strong affinity towards oxygen. Therefore, if you have to reduce these oxide to metal, you will use process of electrolysis. This is a most important reason and I have written here. Next, zinc, iron, lead, copper. If you have to remove obtain metal from its metal oxide, then simply you can use reducing agents like coke, carbon monoxide and hydrogen. Suppose you have zinc oxide and you have to form zinc, then you will use coke to form Zn and Co. By this way you can use other reactions like CuO plus C give Cu plus Co. ठीक है, तो इस तरह से हम लोग coke का use कर सकते हैं. And last two, silver, mercury and silver, these are least stable oxide. On simply thermal decomposition you can get the metal. By the reaction HgO gives Hg plus O2 or Ag2O gives Ag plus O2. So by this way you can obtain the metal, and besides this you have to obtain more pure form of it, then you will do the phenomena of electrorefining. Suppose I have to refine copper, okay, then you will given a pure thin strip of copper and impure block of copper. Then it you have studied in the chapter electrolysis how electrode refining is done. There are two electrodes, anode and cathode. At anode, you will put impure block of metal, which is copper. Cathode, pure thin strip of copper. During refining, it should be remembered that pure strip of metal should be at cathode, so that metallic cation can easily deposited to pure metal, not impure. Electrolyte, what type of electrode you will take? If you have to do the refining of copper, then you will use the aqueous solution of copper sulfate. If you have to do the refining of some other metal like zinc, you will use aqueous zinc sulfate solution. Similarly, the electrolyte should contain the same metal ion. Okay. Then what reaction takes place at cathode? Since electrolyte contains copper ion, then copper ion can easily deposited to cathode. And at the same time, the active copper anode will lose copper into solution. Means, an impure block will lose copper into solution and the ion. Ions of this solution goes to cathode, where it take a necessary number of electron and get deposited as neutral metal over cathode. After removing this cathode rod, you can scrap this metal and get pure metal. Okay. So if you take copper sulfate solution, its copper ion will deposit to cathode by this reaction. Copper ion from the solution goes to cathode, take up 2 electron to form copper deposited. Okay. So by this way, these are the 4 steps in which you can do any metallurgy. In the next video, we will discuss you the metallurgy of aluminium. Keep watching my channel. Peace and classy Vajit Agarwal. Thank you.